Where's George?
George.
George.
Thank you.
I would like to look at you if I evaluate you.
Of course.
George?
I apologize.
You delivered a tremendous speech. I think what you do extremely well during your speech is to show how you deliver an informative speech. A very complex topic and only in 7 minutes. And I think you did a really good job in just giving us that information in that short time. You speak very clearly, and I like it because I think most of the people probably in the back of the room have also heard you. What I like is when you use the informative topic like this, you still use some jokes, because sometimes when you have an informative topic, something that is very information dense, it can be a bit hard, you know, to focus all the time. So it's good that you use these awkward situations that you could might have with the language, if you mix up with characters, and show to us to even use the topic of your speech to make a couple of jokes. Also, the structure was excellent. There was no moment in your speech where I didn't know where you were going and what you were going to tell. You were really clear from the beginning, and I think everybody knew what you were going to talk about, which is very pleasant for the listener, so we don't have any surprises. So, all the good on that. I want to talk first a bit about your performance, about how you were talking, how you were presenting yourself. First, I thought the choice was powerful. Again, I agree, in a situation like this, when you have a lot of information to talk about, it's good to have a PowerPoint. Also because I like to pick the graphic, for instance, where you saw the characters, the audience saw the characters, and it looked like fire, or it looked like water, etc. Because that wouldn't have come across if you would have just told it. Like, would have said, oh, there's some character that looks like this, and it's water, you understand it. So, good thinking on that. What I do would like to say is that because you had a lot of different forms of alphabet, it would be good for you to have one slide with an overview. Like, okay, these are the four ones. Because at a certain point, as a listener, I was thinking, which one was this, and how does it compare to the other? So, other than that, great job. Well, your style. You were basically here all the time, right? Which is annoying for the people over there. I think everybody noticed. You have a PowerPoint, you don't want to walk across it, but if that's been up for a while and most people have seen it already, it's no problem. And you can just walk a bit. And not a problem at all, and it's nice for the people over there who also want to look at your beautiful face. Use your arms more. The arm that was holding the pointer, the pointer was going this and this way, but it was always going stiff, you know? So use it a bit. Alright, then finally, on the content. Tell me a bit more why you are so fascinated with Chinese. I understand you find it a very interesting topic, but why are you so interested in it? And share that passion, not only the competitive advantage. Competitive advantage in the end is enough for that. So with this in mind, and also keeping in mind that you have a lot of knowledge, and we don't, so sometimes talk a bit slower, I think you did a very good job. Congratulate yourself, and the audience should congratulate you as well.